Carnoustie, Scotland, Ben Hogan draws a large following for the final round of the British Open. Frank Stranahan of Ohio gets away, followed by the tiny Texan, Big Ben, to British admirers. He got off to a slow start, but finishes fast, despite some opposition. Like this from Stranahan. The Toledo ace really chipped onto this green. And he winds up in a four-way tie for second after winning the first round with a sizzling 70. Sparkling play, but it was the steel-nerved Hogan, U.S. Open champ, who stole the show and the hearts of the fans. The wee Iceman, they called him in Scotland. He missed a close one on occasion, but by now his lead was too commanding. 73 in the first round, 71 in the second, then a 70. And now he holds out with a record-shattering 68 to take the title. So Ben Hogan joins golf immortals Bobby Jones and Gene Sarazen, winning both the U.S. and British Open titles in 1 year. Dallas, where Rice meets Alabama in the Cotton Bowl before 75,000. Star of Alabama is hit hard, fumbles the ball, and Taylor of Rice recovers. And here it is, that play you've been reading about. Billy Magill of Rice on his way to a touchdown, tackled by Tommy Lewis, the emotional Alabama fullback, who gets off the bench and brings down the speeding Magill. Just too full of Alabama, Lewis said afterwards. Rice got the touchdown anyway, and more. Magill put on the greatest running show in Cotton Bowl history. His three touchdowns helped his team gain a 28-6 victory over Alabama. Nashua, number one, Swamps, number two, in the race of the year. Nashua, with Eddie Otero giving him the whip, breaks fast from his rail position, with Swamps, Willie Shoemaker up hard on his heels. This is a match race, $100,000, winner take all. East versus West. Nashua, the Bel Air beauty, versus the Wonder Horse from California, Swamps, who beat him in the Kentucky Derby. Here at Washington Park outside Chicago, they can settle old scores and new ones. The winner will be named top three-year-old and the horse of the year. Swamps is still running second, but holding on. And the crowd of 36,000 is waiting for the big bay to make his bid. Time is running out. But it is Nashua who opens up in the stretch. Swamps doesn't have it. As it developed later, he injured his right front leg at the start. But right now, all eyes are on Nashua and the veteran Eddie Arcaro, opening up the gap and going on to victory by 6½ lengths. It's all Nashua gaining sweet revenge for his defeat by Swamps at Churchill Downs. California Colt was favored to win, but it's the Pride of the East who brings home the bacon. $100,000 worth. Winner take all. Nashua, Horse of the Year. At Aintree, England, it's really the royal sport, with the Queen and Queen Mother among the thousands present for the Grand National Steeplechase, a 30-jump, 4½-mile route that's called the world's toughest test of horse and rider. This year, a stunning surprise in the finish. A shoe-in victory evaporated when, with 60 feet to go, the Royal Entry Devon Locks stumbled and fell. ESP romps home the winner. Devon Locks at a terrific pace, building up to a last-minute letdown. Mourned by his owner with queenly dignity. Later, 19-year-old Charlie Dumas cleared the 7-foot mark in the high jump, a long-sought feat comparable to the first 4-minute mile. Babe Dietrichson Zaharias is dead of cancer at the age of 42. Her 3-year fight for life ended painlessly in a Galveston hospital as she slept. George Zaharias, her husband, is joined by sports lovers everywhere in mourning her. It's the close of one of the most fabulous careers in sports that began in the 1932 Olympics in Los Angeles. 18 years old, she won 2 gold medals with astonishing performances that made her name a byword. Golf was the favorite sport of the world's greatest woman athlete. Beloved for her warmth and spirit, she won a hero stature by her feats, winning nearly 90 major tournaments, including the Women's National Open 3 times. The first American to win the British Women's Amateur, she received a hero's homecoming from her adopted city of Denver. Now, through the cancer fund she set up recently, Babe Dietrichson continues her last and greatest fight.
Yankee Stadium for the 5th game, with the Yanks and Dodgers tied up 2 games apiece, a pivotal game. Sal Magley is going for his 2nd victory for Brooklyn. Mickey Mantle steps in. Going, going, a home run for the Yankees' great slugger. His third in this year's Fall Classic. First hit off Magley and the first run of the game. The way things turned out, Mickey's blast was enough, though the Yanks did score again in the sixth. Spine-tingling catches thrilled the onlookers. Yogi Berra hits one, and Duke Snider races in for a tumbling catch to electrify the 65,000 fans in the stadium. And more thrills were to follow. Not a Dodger had reached first base off Don Larson, the big right-hander from California, who'd been taken out in the second inning of the second game. One down in the fifth, Larson faces Gil Hodges. Hodges powers one towards left center, but Mantle sprints over for the catch. Mickey saves the day. Larson continues his mastery of the Dodgers. Two out in the ninth, still not a hit. Dale Mitchell is pinch hitting for Magley. He stands between Larson and a perfect game. The tension in the stands is terrific. Here it comes. He strikes him out. The Yanks win a key game 2-0, and Don Larson is baseball's man of the hour. He pitched the first no-hitter in a World Series and the second perfect game in the history of the major leagues.
North Carolina's Tar Heel Quintet, unbeaten in 31 games this year, meets the favored Kansas Jayhawks. Wilt the Stilt Chamberlain and company for the National Collegiate Championship. From the opening moments, Kansas is off its stride as coach Frank McGuire's Tar Heels take the lead and hold it with a tight ball control strategy. Kansas doesn't get a chance for its freewheeling fast break attack, but the Tar Heels keep dropping those goals. North Carolina's cautious strategy isn't very popular, but they stick with it, outshooting the Jayhawks with 21 field goals to 15 for Kansas, whose star, Wilt Chamberlain.